How you doing, folks? This is Rex at the Buckeyenest, and I'm out here at the Dayton V.A. today with the 4 Freedom Equestrian Team. And we got a gentleman here, his name is Art, and this is his rescue horse. He rescued this horse, and his name is Phantom. How you doing, Phantom? You want to say hi to your audience? You're just eating. You were getting awful frisky earlier. He's just getting rid of the flies now, huh?
Yep.
But how long you had Phantom, Art?
I've had Phantom now a couple of years. He's a 12-year-old. Got him when he was 10.
Yeah.
And he'd been in a rescue center for about a year. I didn't know why nobody had taken him, but I came along and he seemed to hit it off. And he makes a great trail horse.
Yeah.
At first, you want to put your foot in the stirrup and he'd take off on you, but now he'll stand and let you get on. And
he was like that. You were feeling pretty frisky earlier, huh?
Yeah.
He says that. So
it's getting a little warm. When they get warm, when it gets really hot, that kind of takes it a little out of them. But cool mornings, they'll be frisky.
Yeah. So, is this the only one you got at your house?
No, I have 2 Mustangs that I've rescued. I've had them since they were yearlings. They're now 8 years old.
Now, those are the 2 you told me about you'd like to find a good home for.
Yes. Yep.
They're not necessarily for sale, but you want to make sure they go to a good home.
They're both broken. The problem is that they've never been separated.
Okay.
So if you're going to take one out,
you really need to take
both of them.
Yeah.
And since it's just me riding, that's kind of hard to do. I have one that I've trained that I really like. It's got a beautiful Jasmine, she's got a beautiful gait.
Yeah.
Her gait and this Tennessee Walker, almost the same, almost as smooth as the Tennessee Walker.
Yeah.
Which is rare in a Mustang.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I understand you're a veteran too, Art.
Yeah.
You're a chaplain?
I'm a chaplain. I was back in 19. Went in 64 to... And then I came out and then I went to seminary and went in combat engineers in the up in Maine in the National Guard, and then I went to Arizona National Guard. Eventually I had to leave because of the church and the military is kind of too much.
Uh-huh.
I've tried to stay in touch and I like doing this program.
How'd you hear about the 4 Freedom Team, Art? When did you hear about them?
I was out here getting a medical procedure or something, and I saw some horses out here, and I just came over and started talking to Leah, and she told me about the program and invited me to come out.
Very good.
That was
very
it.
Good. Leah's a pretty awesome lady.
Yeah,
right?
She is. Yeah. Yeah.
She's pretty awesome here. So.
So I had to take a little time off last year because I had heart procedures. But
yeah,
I'm feeling good. Back at it.
Yeah. So what's the ultimate goal with the Phantom here? When you get him all fattened up and liking life again, gonna keep him or?
Yeah, I'm gonna keep him. What I would like to do with him, one of my goals is to, I've been out west several times and I've always had to borrow a horse out there, but I'd like to go back out west, I like Montana, and actually take him and ride him out there in the mountains. I think he'd be,
That was one of my dreams I always wanted to go buy one of those old missile silos.
Yeah.
Up there in Montana and rehab it and live in it.
Mm-hmm.
It's
a beautiful
But
country.
My brother works out here. He works upstairs on the 9th floor. He's an IT guy.
Mm-hmm.
He tells me that all those old missile silos are all sold now. You can't buy anymore.
Yeah.
So.
No, but it's beautiful country out there.
I can imagine.
I've been out there before but I've never had my own horse out there, and I'd like to do that with him.
Yeah.
He,
so you plan on keeping him then?
Yes. Yep.
Okay.
Plan on keeping him.
So.
Yeah.
Yeah, he is pretty. He does have his own personality.
Yes, he does. Well, this is the first gelding I've ever had because I've always had mares because they have personality galore, but I had one gelding and I got rid of him. He had no personality, but when I came across him, he definitely has personality, and that's what I like.
You know? Well, I saw him kicking up his hind legs a little earlier.
Yeah.
So he was feeling awful good today. So.
Yeah, he likes to play.
Yeah.
I'll get out in the field and I'll chase him and snort at him and he'll snort back at me. like a little kid sometimes.
I have to get some video of that someday.
it's fun.
Yeah. All right, buddy. Well, I'm going to wrap this up here.
Well, thank you. Thank you for stopping
folks,
by.
Folks, this has been Art, and this is Phantom.
Yeah.
And don't forget now, Art's got those two Mustangs he'd like to find a good home for, and he wants to give them away for free, but he wants to be sure you're going to take good care of those horses, and they have to go in a pair.
Yeah.
So, is there a phone number they can call yet,
sure.
Art?
Area code 937-969-8337.
Gotcha.
Okay.
Well, folks, I'm back out here to give you a little more insight about this corral. We got the obstacle course set up inside here today, and one of the neat things about using this corral for that is we don't have to worry about any of the horses going silly and doing something stupid, because they're right inside this corral all the time, and the veterans take them through the obstacle course, lead them around through in there, and teach them different things there and bond with them. And there's the swimming pool full of water. They got to learn to walk through those. And that plastic tarp over there, they have to learn to walk on top of that and go through it. What it is the rustling noise, the rustling effect, and the strange feeling underneath their feet. They have to get used to that kind of stuff. Then we got the low-level hurdle up there. And down through here, over here where the cone's up and those two pieces of wood are on the floor on the other side of this pallet, or on the wood on the ground on the other side of this pallet. They have to walk down through the middle of those, and then they have to come over here, and they actually have to step up and walk over top of the pallet and get all 4 feet on there, hoofs on there. Those things there are the noodles. Horses, believe it or not, get kind of shy of things hanging down low and stuff, so they take them through the noodles and get them used to walking through low-hanging things, and they're kind of like simulated like branches and stuff. So that's what they do with them there. And then they finally take them down through the middle here, and they do figure eights and around and come back through these upright poles here. So got a little bit of a better space to do the obstacle course in, and that's what they're doing today. Right now the veterans are inside going through a training program, grooming program in the training room. And I'm going to walk over here and I'm going to introduce you to the newest member of the team. And his name, or her name, is Montana. And that's her butt sticking out there. Montana, can you come here? Montana! Hi, Montana. This is Montana. She's gonna help out. How you doing, girl? I told you in the past that Tank's got some problems, and he's not gonna be able to do the carriage anymore. So we got Montana here to take over Tank's job. Montana is not as big as Duke. Y'all remember Duke. But she's bigger than Tank, and if you look at the size of those feet, you'll see what I mean. Montana's a part of the Percheron family, and she's a workhorse, she's a draft horse, and she's going to be pulling the carriage as soon as we get it all fixed up. Maybe. I know Leah's got to find out if she'll be okay. Yeah, she's a good girl. And of course, this is Cruz. You met Cruz already, but he's pretty new to the team. Cruz and Montana are being buddies here, huh? Yeah, these horses are great. I miss my buddy Tank, but I suppose I'll get out to the ranch to visit him every now and then. But I'm making some new buddies here. There's Montana wanting some water. And then Tank here, or Cruz, he's got his water over here. Yeah, Cruz is okay, Sue. He's pretty good. He's pretty good. That's the neatest thing about these horses. You've heard me say it 1,000 times, and I'll probably say it 1,000 times. And you can talk to these horses, and they don't talk back. I suppose since Sierra here, hi Sierra, I take Sierra over to the hospice, and she does great with the older veterans over there. Tank's my best buddy, but Sierra's my girl. Yeah, Sierra's my girl. Sierra's my girl. Say hi to your audience, Sierra. Yeah, she wants to cuddle. Sierra likes to cuddle. Problem is you do that, they don't know their own strength, and they can knock down your butt before you realize it. And this is Itty Bitty. Hi, Itty Bitty. This is Leah Shirte's horse. He's a pretty horse. He is. He's a pretty boy. He is. And his name is Itty Bitty. Yeah, he's getting his chow. It's chow time. And this is Harley, folks. He belongs to Jennifer out of Bellwether Farms, and he's getting some chow in there. He says, screw you, I don't want to talk to the internet. I want to eat, huh? Yeah, he's a pretty good boy. He is. You want to say hi to your audience here, buddy? No, you just want to chew. Chew that food, huh? Yeah. He's a pretty horse. Jennifer's getting ready to take him home. That's why he's loaded up in the trailer. They're getting ready to go home for the day. So maybe next week, if he comes back, we'll be able to get some better video of him. But in the meantime, he's digging down in there to get that hay. Yes, you are. Oh, that was sneezing there. Was you sneezing? All right. All right, Harley, you have a safe trip home. Tell Mom to drive safe, okay?